apprehended the mother.
Yes, sir.
That was involved, and tell us how it went down. She was supposed to turn herself in earlier, I think, at 5 o'clock. She failed to do so, but can you tell us the events that led up to her capture?
Actually, at 4 o'clock. We was in constant communication with Ms. Valentine all day yesterday. Started out early in the morning. It lasted till after hours. In our communication with her, she explained to us that, you know, she was going through a difficult time, like we all know, and she wanted to come turn herself in at 4. 4 o'clock then went to 5 o'clock. 5 o'clock then went to 6 o'clock. And it just carried on throughout the night. We had officers out looking for her. We couldn't pinpoint a location as to where we were. We just had her word that she was going to come here. So we had officers stationed here at the police department awaiting her arrival. That didn't take place. We then continued our pursuit and looking for Ms. Valentine. We received numerous calls from, you know, individuals in the community about Ms. Valentine's location. We checked various locations, like I said. And we actually received a phone call like after we finished up with the investigation with the pit bull shortly after midnight on a location of Miss Valentine, and she was located on Grand Cayou Road at a car wash.
Still no idea where the father is?
That's correct.
Lieutenant, did she was at a car wash?
Correct.
Was she getting a car wash?
No, she wasn't getting a car wash. She was actually in a vehicle with someone. We conducted a traffic stop, identified her in the vehicle, and she was apprehended without incident.
Were there any illegal substances also recovered?
Yes, in the process of her arrest, our officers located her in possession of a small amount of marijuana. So she was charged with that as well.
Are there any potentials, or is anything being explored at this point, insofar as any potential charges against anyone else in terms of harboring her or knowing that there was a felony warrant out for her and not contacting her?
Not at this point.
And do we have any indication as of yet that she and the father of the children have been in touch with each other since the funeral?
We know they were together for the funeral, but since the funeral, we don't have any indication that they have been together or in any contact at all.
Thank you, sir. Have y'all been able to prove that there was a pattern of them leaving the children at home prior to them leaving this time in the fatality?
We have some footage that we secured throughout the night that indicated them being away from the residence, but like we said earlier, all of that is still being investigated, as if when they were away from the residence with someone watching the kid at that time. We're still in the process of investigating this as we speak.
But obviously the manslaughter charge that the DA recommended, Joe H. Jr. recommended to you all, was based on the fact that they weren't home.
That's correct.
Lieutenant, on the reports or the video that you had secured, the investigators secured, that would have been the night of fire during the time that the children were alone, correct?
Correct.
And the two of them were together in those videos?
Yes.
Was any of that related to a place where they may have been playing video poker?
We have no reports of them at a location playing video poker.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Can you clarify, we were talking here a little while ago, and there was three different theories on the fire in the home. What exactly happened? How did the fire get started?
We're still receiving various accounts as to what transpired in the home. Those accounts are that they were just outside talking amongst themselves. Some accounts were that they were arguing in the house. Like I said, it's still under investigation as to what led up to the fire starting. So we still have several scenarios that we're exploring that's being reported to us by various witnesses. Any more questions?
All right.
Thank y'all for your cooperation.
Yeah. Thank y'all.
Chief, just one more question.
Sure.
The officers have won the scene, and I think the lieutenant was with them. What are the what's the time period that they go through the counseling and all that? Because obviously, that's a horrific thing.
We setting it up today. We're actually working on it today. We contacted them, and any of them that requires it, we're going to get it to them.
Thank you.
All right, thank y'all.